We are here in a fern and zygote house of the Botanic Garden of the University of Freiburg, which is located in the southwestern part of Germany. My name is Thomas Beck. I'm the director of the Botanic Garden and head of the Plant Biomechanics Group Freiburg. So more than 6,000 species of plants which we cultivate in the Botanic Garden are a real treasure trove for our scientific work. Our scientific interests concentrate mainly on functional anatomy, biomechanics, and on biomimetics. Biomimetics is a branch of science which deals with the transfer of inspiration from nature, in our case mainly plants, to technical applications. In my research institute, we have at the moment 6 different research groups dealing with various questions concerning biomimetics and bio-inspired transfer of ideas from living nature to technical applications. One of the group deals with branched and unbranched fiber-reinforced materials. From an engineering point of view, most plant stems can be regarded as fiber-reinforced materials, which show an interesting branching pattern and a very specific arrangement of the fibers. We especially concentrate on columnar cacti and on arborescent monocotyledons, which have a very interesting branching pattern, a shape of side branches, and a very important structural arrangement of the fibers and fiber bundles. Together with our colleagues from the Baden-Württemberg Network of Competence Biomimetics, and especially the ETV Denkendorf, we try to develop new lightweight fiber-reinforced technical structures which have a high load-bearing capacity and a good damping behavior. This we do also for the application in architecture, where these pillars can be used to support parts of buildings and where the amount of material and energy needed for the support can be reduced. Other fields of application for fiber-reinforced branch and unbranched structures are airplanes, different types of automotives, and also sports equipment. A second research group in the institute studies highly damping and puncture-resistant materials, which are found, for example, in some fruit peels and seed coats. We are especially interested in huge citrus fruits like the pomelo, which have a thick peel that consists of a graded foam, which is embedded in a three-dimensional network of fibers. This pomelo foam was a concept generator for the development of bio-inspired graded metal foams, which we have developed together with colleagues from the RWTH Aachen and the Technical University of Berlin. Additionally, we have also studied puncture-resistant nutshells, and the combination of both can be used for various applications in technology, for example, for crash boxes in cars or for envelopes for the transportation of hazardous goods, for different kind of protecting systems, for example, for skiing or for skateboarding, and also can be used for protection helmets. Here we collaborate closely with various partners from industry which have an increasing interest in these kind of bio-inspired materials, which are typically very lightweight and have a combination of very interesting mechanical properties. In the Institute's third research group, attachment structures of plants are studied. Climbing plants have evolved a huge variety of different attachment structures which secure their attachment to the different supporting surfaces. These attachment structures range from tendrils, some of them with attachment pads, as can be found, for example, in one Passiflora species, to climbing roots, where the plants secure their support with roots and root hairs. These are found, for example, in the English ivy. We are especially interested in the structure-function relationship of these attachment structures, but also in the chemistry, which helps in addition to secure the attachment on the various supports. This is for the plants of high interest, but also of very much interest for a transfer into technical applications, because gluing and attachment in technology becomes more and more important. This not only holds for bringing together small pieces, but also in airplanes and cars, more and more parts are not any longer screwed, but glued together. This project is a collaboration of the Plant Biomechanics Group with partners from macromolecular chemistry and physics from the University of Freiburg, the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology, and Fischer GmbH as industrial partner. The main topic of interest in the fourth research group of the Institute are so-called smart materials in nature and in technical applications. We analyze here self-adaptive structures as they are found in plants, for example, due to changes of the internal turgor pressure in the plant cells, but especially self-healing and self-sealing procedures which are found in a variety of plants. We have analyzed different plants and transferred the idea of self-healing and self-sealing into technical application. One example is the winding liana aristolochia, the so-called Dutchman's pipe. And in this plant, in the growth process, parts of the inner cylinder split. And if these splits would go to the outside, they would be perfect entrance gates for bacteria or fungi spores. Therefore, there exists a high selective pressure to seal these gaps. And this is brought about by cells of the outer cortex, which swell into these gaps and seals them very efficiently. We have transferred this idea to a self-sealing closed-cell polyurethane foam, which can be used for a variety of pneumatic structures like rubber boats or tensility architectural lightweight bridges. Another example are the so-called latex plants. These are, for example, rubber trees or spurges, where the latex, if a wound occurs, seals and heals this wound very efficiently. Together with colleagues from the Institute of Macromolecular Chemistry, we have developed a new bio-inspired elastomer, which seals tiny fissures, so-called microcracks, very efficiently, and set for stays intact for a much longer service time. These elastomers can be used, for example, in dampers or in sealings, and can reduce, for example, the loss of oil or other harmful substances. In the fifth research group of the Institute, plant movements were analyzed. If one speaks about motion or movements, one typically thinks on animals. But also plants show a huge variety of different movements, which not only differ in the time span, but also in the actuation mechanisms. A very well-known motion is the opening and closing of pine cones, which is brought about by differences in air humidity. If the air is dry, the cone opens and the seeds can be spread. If the air is wet, the cone closes. Another type of plant motions we analyze are the so-called active motions, which are typically brought about by changes in internal cell pressure, the so-called turgor. One of the most well-known examples are the traps of the Venus flytrap. If these trapping leaves are touched by a prey animal, they close and catch the prey animal, as you can see here. These plant motions are used in collaboration with architects from the University of Stuttgart for the development of bio-inspired sunshading systems. These sunshading systems are used for modern buildings where huge glass facades are typical. The so-called flectofin was inspired by the pollinating mechanism found in the bird of paradise flower. The flectofin has no hinges and therefore needs very little maintenance and is not at all prone to failure. Based on the flectofin mechanisms, already a variety of sunshading systems was built and incorporated in different architectural buildings. In addition to the topics studied in the various research groups, an item of general interest in the Institute is biomimetics and architecture. Here we work together in a collaborative research center, Transregio 141, with colleagues from the universities of Stuttgart and Tübingen. Together with the architects, engineers, evolutionary biologists, material scientists, we not only want to develop new items for buildings, but we really want to develop a biomimetic architecture which transfers a lot of facilities which we find in nature to architectural buildings. We think that it's of high interest to understand what can be learned from nature to a new, up-to-date architecture. And for this purpose, we also try to analyze the sustainability of this kind of architectural solutions. But one has to be aware that sustainability is not always linked to biomimetics. For each biomimetic solution, it has to be tested if it's really sustainable. I think that all students which are interested in interdisciplinary research find a brilliant field in biomimetics and should really think about to join the bandwagon of biomimetics. If you're interested to learn more about biomimetics, I relate to the internet pages of the Baden-Württemberg Kompetenznetz Biomimetics and of the Plant Biomechanics Group Freiburg.